What's up guys, Chris here from Security Bros, back with another review video, and today I will take a closer look at the new Ezviz C8C, which is Ezviz's first outdoor Wi-Fi pan and tilt security camera. Is it any good? Let's find out. So it looks like we will have another year with new interesting cameras from Ezviz. They have already announced a 4-megapixel bullet camera, which I'm looking forward to review as soon as I can get my hands on one. And hopefully in the future we will also see a full color camera, like the C3X, but with a 4-megapixel sensor instead. So after playing around with the C8C for a few days, I think this is a decent pan and tilt camera overall. The design is kinda unique, and I was surprised how small it is. The whole camera basically fits in your hand. The mounting bracket allows us to mount it both on a wall or a ceiling, and the camera is actually kinda heavy for how small it is, so it does feel like a premium camera, even though it's all made of plastic. But I guess time will tell how well it can withstand the elements. Image quality is kinda what to expect for a camera like this. It's not great, but should be good enough for most situations, unless you're looking for a camera to easily identify people or read license plates at a distance. Then this is probably not the best camera for that. It does have something called AI-powered person detection, which means the camera can tell if it's a human by the shape of a moving object, and then alert you immediately on your smart device. Unfortunately, it doesn't support preset points or patrol, so if you want to move the camera to a new position, you have to do it manually in the app. At the moment it looks like Ezviz C8C is only available in Asia, but I'm guessing they will soon release it in US and Europe as well. I managed to buy the camera from a website called Shopee Indonesia, and I paid around $100 including shipping. It will be interesting to see what the price will be on Amazon. And as soon as the camera is available on Amazon, I will put my affiliate links in the video description below with the most updated prices. So the camera uses a 2-megapixel sensor that can record 1080p at 22 frames per second, and the camera I have uses a 4mm lens, but 6 is available as well. It can pan 352 degrees and tilt 95 degrees, and it doesn't have any zoom. You can use this camera as a standalone camera and have it record to the SD card, and when it detects motion it will send you a push notification to a smart device through the Ezviz app, and you can then view the recorded footage directly in the app from playbacks. You can set the camera to record 24/7 or only when motion is detected, and it supports up to 256GB microSD card. You can also use their cloud storage if you want, or together with an Ezviz NVR, but unfortunately the camera doesn't support ONVIF, so it will not work with third-party NVRs. RTSP stream was no problem using VLC player, and as with all Ezviz cameras, you can't access the camera through a web browser. So to access all the camera settings that are not available in the app, you need to download Ezviz Studio and go to Advanced Settings, which will give you access to all the settings the camera have to offer. The camera also have full color night vision using white LED lights. There are 3 different night vision modes: color night vision, which means the white LED lights are on all the time. And then we have normal black and white night vision using infrared lights. And last, something called smart night vision, which means the camera will turn on the white LED lights when motion is detected, and when there is no motion anymore it will go back to normal infrared night vision. And night vision is same as daytime, not really sharp enough to identify a person unless they are really close to the camera. It also has something called active defense, which means when the camera detects motion it will flash the 2 white LED lights to let people know they are being recorded. Okay, so what we get in the box is the camera, power adapter, quick start guide, weatherproof connector cover, and a bag with screws. On the front of the camera we got the lens, 2 infrared lights, 2 white LED lights, and up here we got the indicator light that you can turn off if you want, and then the microphone. On the back we will find the SD card slot and the reset button, and you can move the bracket this way so you can easily access the screws. To add a camera to the Ezviz app is really quick and easy. First, download the app from either Google Play Store or App Store, depending on what device you're using. When you have the app open, click on the plus icon in the top right corner. Then click Cameras and scan the QR code, which you will find on your camera. When successfully scan the QR code, click Add and select your Wi-Fi, then wait for it to connect. And that's it. So here on the main screen, we can access playbacks, which is video history. Blue is continuous recording and yellow is motion detection. Then we can take snapshots, record video, change image quality, multi-screen, pan and tilt the camera, turn on the strobe lights and privacy mode. The settings menu is in the top right corner, and here we can turn on and off audio, turn on and off the indicator light on the camera, and turn off infrared light. In alarm notification, we can turn on notifications, human shape detection, or normal motion detection. Turn on detection marking if you want the camera to mark around moving objects, and set a schedule when you want notifications. In night vision mode, we can choose between color night vision, black and white night vision, and smart night vision. In storage status, we can format the SD card and turn on 24/7 recording. And that's basically all the camera settings we got in the app. So let's have a look at what settings we have in the Ezviz Studio. I will quickly show all the settings since there are too many to go over one by one. And if there is a settings that you're more interested in, you can just pause the video at any time. Okay, let's have a look at some recordings. Here we have daytime with the highest image quality and audio turned on. And I am at around 10-15 meters from the camera here. Here's another clip where I test the pan and tilt. Unfortunately, it doesn't support preset points. This is at nighttime, but not in complete darkness, since there is a street light just across the street. And here I test the smart night vision. and some pan and tilt at night. This is me testing how long it takes to get the push notifications when motion is detected, and I'm using mobile data here. Alright guys, thank you for watching this video, and if you're interested in more videos like this, don't forget to subscribe and hit that like button. See you next time.